Ah, there we go.
Hi, Megan.
Awesome. I got it. Thank you. All right, bye.
I'm just gonna record everything, probably put it on YouTube, so if you guys could just keep it down, that'd be awesome. Sorry.
Say anything offensive.
No, go for it. I don't know. Just try to be quiet.
I just don't want to see the back of my head. Alright, we're good.
True, but with radio it sort of is. you got to start with the science. Way back in the late 1800s, these crazy European guys, Maxwell and Britain, figures out that light is a wave, man, but it's also particles. And sparks, little electric sparks, can generate these waves. But he's a scientist. He doesn't get his hands dirty. He doesn't actually do anything about it. This German guy, who's a little bit more practical, starts measuring stuff, starts figuring out that there's wavelengths, and he builds this early spark gap transmitter. It's literally two pieces of wire that an electrical spark goes across, and he can make radio waves doing that. But they don't know what that's called, but he figures out how to measure that, and he starts playing around with it. But again, he's a scientist. He's not an inventor, so he just kind of writes this up and says, oh, yeah, this is very interesting. It takes somebody else to take this and run with it. That's this guy. Guglielmo Marconi, Italian, has an Italian father and an English mother. That's important later on. He recognizes that you can do something with this science. That, hey, you can send messages through the air. You don't need wires to do this. And wireless telegraphy. And that's what the idea was. That we can send telegraph messages, .. all that sort of stuff, through the air without using wires. Works on it for a while, can transmit a few miles. By 1896, he gets a patent in England, which he can do because his mom is English. Why not Italy? Think about it a little bit. We'll get back to you. 1899, he transmits across the English Channel. 3 years later. Across the Atlantic. 2 years later. That's a pretty big scale up. From 20 miles to like 4,000. Opens the system up to the public to send messages. 1907. Now we already at this point have undersea cables running between the US and Britain and Europe and all around the world. So who's the market? Why did he get a patent in England? What does England have the largest of in the world?
Navy.
The Navy, yeah. Who can't use a regular telegraph?
Navy.
The Navy, ships. That's the market. That's who needs this wireless telegraph stuff, is anybody on a ship. So that's why he goes and patents it in England. And the users in these early years is pretty much navies, as well as commercial ships.